Teams having to play their qualifiers elsewhere because of Ebola. The tournament moving from original hosts Morocco to Equatorial Guinea. And then there was the story that the defending champions Nigeria would be unable to compete after being dumped out by a revived South Africa. The team is completely transformed under coach Ephraim Shakes Mashaba, the only man who managed to qualify two national teams for continental competitions in the same year. He was also recently awarded Coach of the Year at the SA Sport Awards. He joins us now in studio. Welcome, Coach.
Morning, Villain, and morning to our viewers at home.
It's such an honour to have you in studio. Yesterday, you released your provisional squad of 34 young men that will be doing battle at the Africa Cup of Nations. Do you just want to tell us a little bit about the squad? Some saying we've got Tokelo Ranti, he's struggling with injury. Do you want to just tell us a little bit about the makeup of this team that you have?
Yeah, thanks. The makeup of this squad, it's supposed to be 36 in number, but we had 34. We're still looking at maybe one or two players that we can rope in. Yes, I've seen the headlines talking about Parker Bear being brought back. He's been a player in the national team. We brought him in case of Ranti doesn't get well. You'll remember he had a shoulder dislocation, and we've been making a follow-up. But the good thing is that he's recovering very well. I think he'll be available. But with the backup of Baka, we don't have problems in that area.
Why leave out Kermadi Rasmus and Lehlon Olumadjo?
Most unfortunately, I don't know whether I should say fortunately as well. We're looking at the players' current form, you know, and what are they doing in their clubs. And if you look at now, lately, most of our strikers are struggling to find the net. But we felt, let's go on with those players that we've been using since we started the qualifiers. And there's nothing much we can say about them not being in the team. But until the last time we announce and finalize our squad into 23 that's going to go through to Equatorial Guinea, anyone still has a chance to come back.
All right, so people can still play for their places. I mean, you speak about current form, and one man that has been, seems to have found his form again for his club is Sipiwe Shabalala. So you say that other people can still play their way back into the squad in this final round of PSL matches that we'll have this weekend?
Yeah. Yes, let's talk about the current form. The only thing is we're looking at the different positions. Goalkeeping, defending, midfield strikers, as well as those who sit on the bench. It's about the current form. Yes, we admit and accept that Spiwe has shown some form. But if you look at in the list that we gave, the number of midfield players, you can make a team out of them. So to keep on bringing more players, it will confuse us. But like as I indicated, everyone still stands a good chance to come back in the team until we announce our final 23.
The final 23 will be announced on the 30th of December. That's when you'll make your final team announcement of the 23 that will do battle in Equatorial Guinea. Will Dean Furman retain the captaincy?
That is one other thing that I want to make clear to people. The mandate given to us was to build up a new side. And people are looking at the playing side alone. We need role models as well. We need leaders as well. We're not going to take this position and confine it to one player. We want to rotate that. We won't say, yes, going to Equatorial Guinea, Dean will be a captain. Every player that shows good leadership qualities stand a good chance to be a captain. With me, I would have loved that we rotate our captaincy to prepare our players going forward. But up to the last game we played, yes, Dean was the captain of the team.
All right, but that's not permanent, is the final word from Coach Mashaba. Let's speak about AFCON now. Let's speak about the test that awaits in Malabo. People calling our group that we've been drawn in Group C the proverbial group of death. Your immediate reaction was, come on, supporters, don't be calling this a group of death. We can get through these teams. I mean, having sat back now and looking at the teams, Ghana, Senegal and Algeria, all of them ranked higher in world rankings than South Africa. Your feeling on our group, and are you still confident we can get through it?
Let me say, yes, it is a tough group. If you look at Algeria, they're number one in Africa. Senegal, they've been doing well. They've got a couple of good foreign-based players. Ghana, yes, but I think Ghana, we are more or less in the same level with them. They are building up a new side. Group of death, that's what this group is termed. Unfortunately, nobody says who's going to die in the in that group. So I always say in everyone's life, there's always first time. And this will be the first time that we dominate the group of death, as people are terming it.
I mean, nobody can fault you, because I suppose it was because of South Africa that Nigeria are no longer able to actually defend the Africa Cup of Nations crown. This is how it looks for South Africa, and it couldn't have started in a more difficult way. You face off against the Desert Foxes of Algeria on Monday the 19th. How are you going to look at managing the team as you go through the group stages? Because that is the focus first and foremost.
I think it is a good fixture that we're looking at. And why I'm saying that, most of the times, first games in the tournament, unpredictable. Nobody can tell you we're going to win, we're going to do what. So it is going to be important for us to motivate our players, keep them motivated. And I'm not going to sit and study the other team's strong points, because that will lead us into paralysis. What we're going to do, let's work on our strong points. Look at where we're good and what can we utilize to sort of like go beat those Algerians. I think our boys up to this far, I mean, where we come from, they should still be motivated. Most unfortunately, my worry is we're going into camp on the Boxing Day after Christmas. I don't know if the players will be ready for that. But I think we've got professional players. They will definitely heed to the call. And I'm sure all 36 players that will be calling in, they'll be looking forward to go and cause a havoc down in Equatorial Guinea.
All right, so we've got some fighting talk from Coach Shakes Mashaba. We're going to continue this interview. Coach, if you don't mind just waiting for headlines after headlines, and we can come back, because we want to find out about this celebration. You have to explain to us where that celebration comes from. No. All that and so much more. Let's get our headline news first.